We want to write an equation for the rational function based upon the given graph. To do this, we'll use the factored form of a rational function given here below, where a is a constant, and then we'll have factors in the numerator and in the denominator. Before we do this, we want to identify all of the key components of the given graph. For example, notice how we have a hole here at x equals negative 3. This graph does not appear to have an x-intercept, but it does have a y-intercept here of negative 2. This is the point 0, negative 2. And we do have a vertical asymptote here at x equals 1. This is enough information to determine our rational function. But we do have to remember that knowing there's a hole at x equals negative 3 gives us information about a factor in the numerator and in the denominator. And knowing we have a vertical asymptote of x equals 1 gives us information about a factor in the denominator. And then we can use the y-intercept at this point here to determine the value of our constant a. So let's begin to set this up. We'll have f of x equals a, we'll find a in the next step, times a rational function. And let's begin with the information about our hole. If there's a hole at x equals negative 3, that means negative 3 is a 0 of both the numerator and denominator, meaning negative 3 makes the numerator and denominator equal to 0, which means they both must contain a factor of x plus 3. Notice x equals negative 3 makes both the numerator and denominator equal to 0, and we should also recognize that common factors here make holes in the graph. And because we have a vertical asymptote of x equals 1, 1 must be a 0 of the denominator, or the value of x equals 1 must make the denominator equal to 0. Therefore, we must have a factor of x minus 1 in the denominator. Now we have everything but the value of a, and we can determine the value of a using the y-intercept. If this function contains the point 0, negative 2, that means f of 0 must equal negative 2. So if we substitute 0 for x, this function must equal negative 2. And if we do this, we can solve for a. F of 0 would equal a times, again, if x is 0, this would be 3. This would be 3 times negative 1, or negative 3. And this value must be equal to negative 2. 3 divided by negative 3 is negative 1, so we have negative a equals negative 2. Divide both sides by negative 1, we have a equals 2. Which means our rational function is f of x equals, since we have 2 times this fraction, we could put the 2 in the numerator, so we'd have 2 times the quantity x plus 3 divided by the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x minus 1. Notice how the degree of the numerator is 1 and the degree of the denominator is 2. When the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, the horizontal asymptote is y equals 0. So just to check, looking at our graph, it does look like we have a horizontal asymptote here of y equals 0, which would be the x-axis. I hope you found this helpful.